sharpen your claws, film fans, because we are here in London's Leicester Square on the red carpet for one of the most anticipated blockbusters of the year, ready to meet the stars of the Wolverine. Why did you want to bring this version and vision of the Wolverine to this big screen?
When I was shooting X-Men 1, we were not allowed to read comic books, right? So the director said no one, and someone slipped, it was like contraband, someone slipped this particular comic book, the Japanese story, the samurai story, under my trailer door, and I read it. And I immediately went to Lauren Shilladonna, the producer, I said, this is going to be a movie. That was 13 years ago, and I kind of can't believe that we're here, we've done it. I think it's intriguing. It's one of the best stories from the comic book series, and to bring it to life, I think this movie feels fresh, different from any of the other X-Men or Wolverine movies. It won't matter if you haven't seen one before. This to me is the definitive Wolverine. This is the Wolverine.
It takes him down to arguably the lowest we've ever seen him and watches him fight back against villains, the likes of which we really haven't put against the Wolverine before, in a way that's unique.
That you really asked Hugh to go sort of angry, I guess the best way of describing it is more berserk than he had ever been before in this film.
I don't think, I felt like I hadn't seen, I'd heard about the berserker rage when I was growing up reading the comics, I had read about the berserker rage, but I wanted to see the berserker rage. And that involves setting up some set pieces of action, I think, where you just see him slice and dice, and you see him go at it. There's no jumping up and grabbing helicopters and bringing him down to the ground. This is a Logan with his feet on the ground, leveling mayhem with his claws.
It was hard to find out the best distance between Hugh, because he has a famous claws like this long, and then I had two swords in my hand. But his claw is short, but his reach is twice as much as mine. And then his one step is my three steps. So it's very hard to find out the best distance, but he's a great fighter.
She has a magnificent sword in the movie. Is that one of the new skills you had to learn for this film? Because you are awesome with it.
Oh, thank you very much. I had 3 weeks training before we start filming, but I never done any action stunt, so I had 3 weeks, but I only had 3 weeks.
Only 3 weeks, because you're magnificent with it. That's fantastic. The fights are great. They're like really painful ballets.
It is. I mean, you know, I remember shooting a scene in Japan and we were on top of the rooftops, and that was probably the scariest thing.
I think this is the best movie focused on like a lot of elements like samurai, ninja, bullet train, yakuza. There's no movie like this.
You're working on X-Men Days of Future Past as the character, the Wolverine as well. And you've taken a break from filming to be here, but we actually have a special message from the set of X-Men Days of Future Past for you to have a watch now.
Hey Hugh, it's your buddy here, Brian Singer. On the set of X-Men Days of Future Past here in Montreal. We're missing you terribly. We've got your claws, we've got your chicken breast. But seriously, have a great premiere. Have a really great time, and we'll see you soon. And to the fans out there, I've seen the movie, and I think this is the Wolverine film you've all been waiting for. Enjoy.
That's nice, isn't it?
It is nice, and that's exactly how I wrote it. So he really did a great job. No, that's we are having a blast. I got to tell you, 13 years ago, Brian gave me this role. It's a role that changed my life. I'm forever grateful to him. I'm forever grateful to the fans. I love playing Wolverine. We're having such a good time on Days of Future Past. I'm telling you, the fans are going to love it.
We ended on such a high note at X-Men The Last Stand. At the end of it was the killing of Wolverine, you know, Wolverine killing Logan killing the Jean Grey / Phoenix character, that I think a lot of people felt kind of robbed of the emotions they wanted to feel at that moment, and sort of having some payoff, and that we have now.
This is Curtis A, who says, oh, and this is a key character in the film, if you had to describe the Silver Samurai in one word, what word would you choose? I'm going to give you three, because that might be impossible.
A mystery only the film will answer. I'm sorry, Curtis. To go there would be ruining the third act for you. I'm sorry.
Okay.
What you've seen in the trailer is as much as you're going to see in here until you see the film.
Have you got a message for all the fans here in Leicester Square and watching across the world?
Well, to all the fans, I know it looks strange, I'm not looking at you, but I am looking at you. thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. These last 13 years playing this character is something I will never forget or treasure all my life. And the reason I'm doing it for so long is you guys. So thank you so much.